Hello and welcome to this presentation. My name is Dan Lopez and I'm the application specialist for Tekla PowerFab here at Trimble. And today's tips and tricks video will be more about general EPM Go capabilities that you may or not be using. We want everybody here to have a good feeling about what you can do in EPM Go. Alright, so for those who haven't heard of EPM Go, EPM Go is a web browser application that works together with Tekla EPM, and they both are part of the Tekla PowerFab bundle, and it helps tremendously to get real-time information from the shop floor and or the erection site too. I will not go very deep on each one of the tools, but we'll have future videos for some of those topics in particular, and you can always also contact your help desk area so they can give you some guidance about any of these topics in particular. Or also you can contact your sales representative, so if you would like a more in-depth demonstration, we can make it happen. Okay, so let's begin. I'll begin to sign with my Trimble identity. You can either use this or your Tekla EPM user. Now, the first screen that you'll see after you log in, it's all the active jobs in production control, and this list may usually be very long, so you can always use the job grouping to filter the jobs, or simply type a few characters in the find job box will also help you to find the job that you are looking for in particular. Now, before we go into any job, there are tools that can help with the general tasks. For example, the general inspections, which can be used to store general audits or different quality related records, like internal AISC audits or maintenance records. For example, I'll show you real quick a welding machine inspection that can help you to keep track of your maintenance plan. If I select here my welding machine weekly inspection and proceed to perform it, I'll just go ahead and create a new record. And you can design these formats, right? So you can put anything that you need to usually fill out in paper. And just by doing that, you will have this as an electronic record now. The time tracking tool, it was created to either enter or import time tracking data to be associated at the job level. Or if you want, you can take this to the scheduled task level. So in that way, regular and overtime hours will both be related to the project schedule and the production schedule also. And that will help with a comparison with the planned hours against the estimate. Now the hours can be manually input, or as you can see here, I can just click N and that will pull the hours from my device. Or I can actually just go in and make modifications and the calculation will come also from that manually modification too. We could also use EPM Go to move material in the yard. Some shops provide their forklift driver with a tablet or a cell phone so they can be updating the locations and basically any of the material that they move around or receive from any vendor. And this will provide you with a real-time inventory information in any moment. It's super simple. You can just go and select the location where you are pulling the material from. You choose the material that you are moving, the new location, you confirm that and it's done. Your inventory is updated. And as I mentioned, the reception can be also possible based on a PO in particular or a job number. Now, going back to my projects screen, let's open the platform job. And the first thing I want to show you here is how the screen has three different representations of the menu. We have the box menu at the center, and then we have the over top menu, and lastly, the drop down menu here on my left. Any of those options, they work the same. And if you see this on a cell phone or a tablet, it will get actually adjusted accordingly to the screen size. So you don't need to zoom in and out to see the actual menu in a full manner. All this is important because it makes EPM Go so simple that anyone can actually use it without being a technological guru. You can access the Trimble Connect model from the upper right corner, but also it's accessible from the assemblies box. So just imagine yourself trying to understand a drawing view, and you can just be on the shop or direction side, click in the assembly that you are looking for, and Trimble Connect will just take you to that piece in particular, zoom into it. You will be able to see the boom from here or see the production status, for example, of that piece. I can see what's been done either in the shop or the job site. or I can just switch to the actual bill of materials. Is that what you are looking for? And see any details that you may want to know about it. In this model, you can also use the organizer and colorize based on the status on some other attributes. But you could see that more in depth in the last webinar for the 2020 features. I'll just show you real quick what I'm talking about. If I show the data table, and what I will do here is just include for now some EPM tables. That's the only thing that I will show on the screen. So let me just remove all those filters, show EPM, and just include some of the production tables that we have here, like the material status. I will include that one, the shape. I will include my shipping status, also maybe the production status, and that's it for now. Well, the sequence too. Let's click OK, and you can see that now that's the data that we have here on the tables. So I will first pick, let's say, let's go with the material status here over the top. So, and then I will just colorize the model based on that, and then you will be able to see what material it's on requisition, what material it's been taken from the stock, etc., etc. Let me remove this and just do one more real quick. Let's go with the production status that and colorize it. And you see now how the model shows the color based on the status of the fabrication of those pieces. Now, going back to the main interface, something that make EPM Go very useful to go paperless is the drawing visualization. No matter where you are, as long as you have internet connection, you can get the files, and that's very, very helpful. Just imagine if you were an erector and your foreman called you to the 10th floor to check any issue or something. And once you are there, you realize that you need the drawing, right? So you just pull your cell phone, open the drawing, and check any details that have to be checked. And that will save you a lot of time, and it can be very, very helpful in some situations. Now, you may have thousands of drawings in there. So the best way to find a drawing is either type in a few characters or filter by a sequence or a lot number from the sequences box or the filter drop down over the top right corner. And have in mind that when you filter, that is being applied to every box. So cut list, inspections, and everything will be reduced on the main screen to the selected filters. As you can see, the drawing number and everything was reduced. Now, passing over to the categories and the subcategories, those can be used as filter as well, but also as quick summary for job data, as you can see here on the screen. Those fields are free use filters. So I have seen big shops using, for example, the category as the shop location where the pieces are located once they are finished. So they can very easy filter that and create a load based used on the pieces on a particular yard location. Okay, so now it's the turn to inspections, and this is a very powerful tool. And we will develop content for tips and tricks videos about this in particular, but for now it's worth to comment that EPM Go is very, very helpful for inspections, because just as we saw with the welding machine maintenance records inspection, you can digitalize your inspections and even keep a picture as a backup of the piece itself. And the inspection can save you a lot of time just because being electronic records, you could put together a quality dossier like in seconds, super fast in any job. And here you can see a little bit of what I'm talking about. Just I'm selecting the test type. I will say this failed actually. And I'll say this, there was some porosity on the piece. So I'll go and add a file. And since I have this from my cell phone, it's asking me if I want to pull actually the camera or just pull an image from my gallery. So in this case, I'll just pull this welding porosity from my gallery and submit this task. And now it's ready to be pulled into my dossier. We also have some project management tools available from EPM Go. For example, you can access a view of your project Gantt chart. So in that way, you can always be prepared for those unexpected meetings that you may have on the job site or with the contractor. You can always see the percentage of completion of the different tasks that you have on your project. You can also go to the transmittals, that it's not just a number of transmittals. You can clearly see what it's overdue or not. open the transmittals and even see the drawings that were included in each one of those. If I close these, now let me go using the top menu to go to the change orders, for example. The change orders will show you the format that you submitted. You can see here this one is overdue, and if I go to the details, I will see everything that I'm trying to get paid for, which in this case is an extra stair. I can actually see the file that it's attached to that change order, and it will be available from anywhere you are. And lastly here, the request for information, where you can actually see the status and the information inside of the RFI, and even open the attachments that you may have received, either the answer or the question. Both will be available in EPM Go. Then we have electronic cut list, which is one of the most liked features of EPM Go, and that is because a saw or plasma operator could be at their control station and even use the machine computer they have and the proper equipment if the internet is available, and see the cutting instructions from there, get a pick list, get an NC1 file, or just simply update the inventory and the production tracking at the same time. So this is very helpful for real-time data information. Also, material status is available, and you can clearly see in a quick way how much it's been taken from the stock, how much it's waiting to be cut, waiting to be received, or even waiting to be purchased. Tracking the fabrication and erection and get real-time information is probably the main purpose of EPM Go. And here you could also identify pieces, like if I go here to the layout weld station, you can see the B51 assembly. It has some inspection failures on it. So also the B52, it's on hold. So all this information can save you errors and time on the shop in pieces that doesn't have to be fabricated at that moment. Also from a couple of versions behind, the production status screen is also available in Go. Here I have a quick summary by sequence, but I can go more in details and also show some of my stations and show the main mark and also Bismarck or any other group. Just let me refresh this, and you will see now that the production status is very similar to the one that you have access from Tekla EPM. So lastly, the shipping status feature allows you to be side by side of the truck with a tablet, creating a shipping ticket on the fly or based on a preset list from the project management area. And this avoids tons of mistakes. I know what it is to receive napkins as a shipping draft ticket and try to guess the main marks that are writing down it there, and that produces several mistakes. So by actually using the bill of material as the base of your shipping tickets and just being able to select from it the main mark that you are actually putting into the truck, you will close the gap and trust your tickets more and more every day. So here, for example, I can go to the load number 1 and show you what the shipping ticket looks like. It's very simple. You just go and select the report that you want to use, include notes if you want, or logo or cover sheet, and you can generate it straight from the tablet or the cell phone, like in this case. And that will just give you the report that you can print and hand to the driver, and it's already. And this is updated also in the production status or the model colorization, where it will show up as done. A good tip also from some fabricators is to have an station on your routes for receive on job site. That can help with the track of the reception between what it's been shipped and what it's been received on the job site to make sure everything is used right. Okay, well, I think that's going to do it for today. As I mentioned at the beginning, this was intended to show you a quick overview of all the things that you can do in EPM Go. So hopefully this helped you, and please leave any comments so we can take those in account for future videos. And thank you for watching.